Okay, you can say now. So please, the audience, pay full attention. Listen to the presenters, to the group, and then we clarify all together at the end. At the end. Because if we clarify along the way, maybe we cannot finish. But I think if you agree, we can take the whole day just to discuss about this. Because it is interesting. Interesting. How many slides do you prepare? Hello? Oh, just 27. Or 27. I don't know whether you can cover enough or not. Okay, let's start now.
Teacher, you record or not?
Yes, already, whenever.
Yes. The first all time, I would like to pray my respect of venerable in our class. Good morning, teacher.
Yes.
And good morning, everyone. Today, my group presentation talk about the 38 sublime blessings. Yes, this is my topic, our group topics. Yes, my group member, they are seventh member. The first, Venerable Rumrati, is me. Second, Miss Sansrilea. Third, Miss Ken Srinuan. Fourth, Miss Jao Srinit. Fifth, Miss Sam Srithom. Sixth, Mr. Pani Choso. And the last, Miss Sia Kaucharanai. Yes. Now remove the slide. One more. Yes, this is our content, talk about the 38 Supreme Blessing. One, the background story of the Mangala Sword or Supreme Blessing. Second, introduction. Third, five part of 38 Supreme Blessing. We have five. First, the essential blessing. Second, the supporting blessing. Third, the personal blessing. Fourth, the higher blessing. Fifth, the supreme blessing. And number four, concluding. Number five, reference. And the last, we have the question and answer. Yes. Now remove the slide. Now we talk about the background of Mangala Sword or Sublime Blessing. Yes, the first I would like to tell you about the meaning of Mangala Sword. What the meaning? What does it mean of Mangala Sword? Yes, the word Mangala or Sublime Blessing mean that blessing a good omen, a good auspices, a good fortune. And the Mangala is a good action which appear or progression, especially it is blessing with all people with to get in this universal. Yes. One more thing, Mangala or Supreme Blessing, it can occur when the people practice it. When we practice it carefully, we are going to get the blessing. Yes, now we talk about some story about the background. Yes, in the ancient time, India had a three group of the teacher who had different opinion and they always believe their thought. There are three of teacher. Oh, sorry, I forgot the word three. Yes. There are three of teacher. The first is the sin of teacher, or we say We say tattha teacher, heard of teacher. We call about sattha teacher, and the tasking or tasked of teacher. We call him about mutta teacher. Mutta teacher, yes. The tattha teacher said that what are we seen, we can call the sublime breathing. Sattva teacher said that what we are heard, we are about to call sublime breathing. And the last teacher said that what we are tested, we will say sublime breathing. You can remove the other slide.
So sorry, Venerable, let me emphasize a little bit to clear about this. Yes, the achatat in Khmer we call achatat. That means yes, the teacher. That they believe that the body, the form, that when we see the beautiful form, we enjoy it like that. So
yes,
they believe that the form is the supreme blessing, because when we see like here, the beautiful angel, like in society, the beautiful girl, the handsome boy, like that, when we see that form, that body, we feel appreciate. So it is miangkul, it is blessing. Like that. And the other teacher said that, yes, I agree. When we see the beautiful girl, the handsome boy, the good picture, yes, we enjoy. How about the bad pictures? How about the ugly form? Do you enjoy?
Yes.
That's why it is not the blessing. The form, not the blessing. And about the word hurt. That means the sound. When we listen to music, it good sound, the good song, yes, we appreciate. So those teachers consider as the blessing. But finally, how about the bad sound? Do you enjoy it? No. That's why sound is not the blessing. Taste. Yes, someone enjoy with eating. They may feel that, oh, taste very important. Taste make me happy. But how about the bad taste? Bad smell. That's why it is not the blessing. Yes, you can continue, Venerable.
Yes. Some people believe seeing because they follow about the top teacher. Some people believe hearing. They follow about the mutta teacher, and some people believe tested or testing. They follow about the mutta teacher. Even though the Theravada or deity always sought as the people, they spent around 12 years ago, but they could not find a way to get the blessing. After that, the Theravada go to ask the king of Theravada or deity. Nick, he asked them back, what happened? Why did they actually together? And where the Mangkulasot come from? Why you always talk about, you spend a lot of time about the 12 years to talk about it? After that, the Theravada or deity said that it comes from the human place, it's human birthplace. When the king of Theravada heard like this, they said that if they come from that place, you should or you must go to the Buddha who stay in Chetapun Pagoda. Yes, to Chetapun Pagoda. When they heard like this, they go to Chittapun Pagoda, and then he asked the Mangalasot from the Buddha. When the Buddha hear about this question already, he applied and talked about the 38 sublime blessings. This is a background, some background of the Mangalasot. Now we move to the other slide. Yes. Now we talk about the interaction. Yes. When the Theravada, the Buddha teach and talk about the 38 of sublime blessing, the one venerable can heard is that here is the Anand. So the interaction you can, yes, yes. Now we start about introduction about the Mangalasot. This is Mangalasot that I am Anand who have heard that. One upon a time, it was in the middle of the night, a certain deity with his surpassing splendors come to visit the Buddha at the monastery of Anathapindika in the Jetha goes near Savatthi. He asked the Buddha for the true meaning of the blessing. In response, the Buddha delivers a discourse known as Mangalasot or sublime blessing, in the way the 38 highest blessing were the ensured numerated. Mangalasot is customarily chanted for the blessing on the auspicious occasion. Besides these, the 38 blessing and the spiritual and the nature providing a step by step the training on the journey of life. It one of the liberation from the suffering, especially sublime blessing, is a prayer in some merit making as well. This is the word that the first venerable heard from the Buddha. Yes. And in the Mangalasot of sublime blessing, the Buddha said there are 38 highest blessings in life, and the 38 blessings can be categorized into the five different groups. They are the essential blessing, supporting blessing, personal blessing, higher blessing, and supreme blessing. Yes. Now we finish about the introduction. Now we remove to other slide, talk about the essential blessing, talk about the Miss Ken Sri Noon. Yes. Thank you so much for everyone.
Thank you, Venerable, and good morning, teacher, and everyone. So, part one, the essential blessing, one to avoid the company of fools. Those who track us down with their foolishness, track card, labeled, etc. So, fools are people who are unable to tell right from wrong and as a result cause harm to others through their action. They are not concerned with basic morality as they do not care very much about the consequence of their action. By associating unmindfully with such people, it will be difficult to make any kind of material or spiritual progress as there is always the tendency to behave in a similar manner. Furthermore, there will be hardly any desire or motivation to do good deed or improve oneself. However, we must be prepared to learn assistance if it is needed and also help others to improve themselves. However, they are fullness, but we should not totally avoid from them. We can help them to do something good, like we can help them to be a good person in the society. So But before we involve with them, we must remind ourselves that we never allow ourselves to be adversely influenced by them.
Yes.
So number two, to associate with the wife. Let me remind
you a little bit. Your explanation very good, but finally you have to make conclusion a little bit for one principle like avoid the company of fool. Yes, so we avoid the company of fool. That means we are not allow them to change our behavior, to change our mindset, to influence our lives. But it does not mean we do not try to advise them, try to support them. We try in the way that we can support them, but make sure do not allow them to influence on our lives. Okay, like that. Just a summary for the audience to understand clearly. Yeah, I appreciate your explanation very good. Yes, very good. You read very well. You read very well. Okay, good.
Yes, thank you, teacher. Two, to associate with the wise, those who encourage us to grow spiritually, the Buddha emphasized the importance of good companionship in many ways. When Ananda remarked that good friends were half of the holy life, he replied saying not so, good friends are the whole of the holy life. So the wise are those who have acquired the wisdom to tell right from wrong and those avoid causing harm to others. They are aware that their actions have consequence on not only their present life, but in their future life too. They discourage wrongdoing and incorrect doing good deeds. We should always try to associate with such upright and virtuous people as proper friendship are of absolute importance in our life, no matter what state of progress we have reached. For example, we can associate with the wise, like our teacher, our friend who always doing something good, and for the elder who always give good advice and encourage about the doing good.
Yeah, very good. I want to emphasize a little bit about this. You see, when Anand remarked that, good friend. When we have good friend, like we have reached half of holy lives in the Sangha community. But in your case, if you have good friend, that means you have reached half of your way of learning, of the learning situation. But the Buddha here, the Buddha replied, you have good friend are the whole of your of the holy life, not only half, but the whole. So the same thing in your case as the student, if you have good friend, the friend who want to learn, the friend who make effort to learn, the good have good behavior like that, so more or less you influenced by that. So finally, you can graduate successfully, and you can develop yourself in terms of moralities, in terms of spirituality, like that. Okay? Finally, you can learn good from the good friend. That's why very important to associate with good friend. Yes. Thank you.
So next slide. Three, honor those who are worthy of honor, making puja to the triple jewel. Honoring our teachers and elders to have this opportunity is a blessing not to be missed. So our parents, elders, and teachers are the people we should honor and respect. We can respect them materially or through our conduct. By giving them their respect and honor, we can benefit from their guidance and continue to learn from them. So it means that we need to respect who are worthy of respect, like our teacher, our elder, our parent, and not to respect to the like gangster or drugger. It's not benefit for us to respect